name is Knut Holst, and today I want to show you the differences between the different kinds of ceramics, of tableware and porcelain by a very simple system, by a very simple method, which is made from the light. For that, I have here a very common flashlight, which you can buy in every electric store. And I want to show you the differences of the material by transparency. For that, I need to close the light and I need to close the windows. And please give me 1 minute to shut down the light and to close the windows. I come back very soon. Here I am back and I turn on my flashlight. As I told you, this is a very normal LED flashlight, which you can buy in every electric store. So I have prepared different stacks of materials and I start with the German brand porcelain. This is the quality of Kera cream from Bausche in Germany. And I want to show you the transparency of this plate. I think you can see very easy and in a very good light the transparency of this kind of porcelain body. This is true feldspar, this is true hard porcelain. Next plate I have, this is made from Schönwald. This is shape number 898. And I think also you can see the transparency very easy. So this is a very good symbol that this is a high quality porcelain. I have also a normal porcelain quality from Bausche, which is shape number 6200. And I think also here, very good viewable, the transparency of the material, the transparency of the body. So you can be sure that these plates are really true porcelain. Coming to the next group, this is the high alumina porcelain from Holst in Germany. This is our brand. This is from the shape Fine Dining. And I want to show you that the transparency of this plate is similar to the premium branded porcelain from Germany. I think you can see the illumination from the body very good. Just to compare again, the plate from Bausche, like this, and the high alumina plate here from Holst porcelain. So you can see that also our high alumina porcelain is a true kind of porcelain, a real kind of porcelain. I brought some more plates with me. This is from Jubiliana, the Arcadia shape. Also a good quality hotel porcelain. And you can see the transparency very good and very easy. To compare Ljubljana Arcadia to the German Holst brand, which is made in alumina porcelain, also you can see here very clear the transparency of our alumina body. And I think it is viewable that the transparency of our plate is much more viewable than the plate from the normal feldspar porcelain. Just to compare again, this is the Jubiliana plate and this is the Holst porcelain plate. Both of them are true porcelain. Coming to another material, this is from India. This is a newcomer in the porcelain industry and the transparency is much more or less. These come from the firing temperature. The firing temperature of this porcelain, they told porcelain, this is 1260. degrees. So it is very nebulous, a little bit diffuse if this is a true porcelain or not. Here we have another plate. This is the cook plate from Holst porcelain, also in the high alumina quality. And I think the illumination, the flashlight is very easy to see. So now we are coming to another kind. We went to the German market and we bought several plates where we believe that it is not a true porcelain, even it was displayed as true porcelain. So the selling companies from the Horeca market and from some private retail stores, they displayed this kind of plate as porcelain, and we do the test. You see, I still have my flashlight on and I do the light testing, and I think you can see nothing. There is no light, so this is a very clear symbol. This is not true porcelain. We do the same with this plate, and I think also you can see nothing. You cannot see the transparency. Also this plate, no light, no transparency. This is not porcelain. This is not porcelain. This is not porcelain. This is not porcelain. No porcelain. Now it's understandable and viewable that the transparency of the porcelain is coming from the glazing. And the glazing, I don't mean the glaze on top. I mean the glazing during the firing procedure. You need to imagine that in a level of 1320 degrees plus, the raw materials, kaolin, feldspar and quartz, they are smelting together. This is like a big glue of raw material, and millions of very small crystals comes out. This kind of crystal we call mullit. Mullit is a kind of crystal which we have a very expensive, a very raw kind of raw material in the nature, but this kind of mullit comes out when the raw materials, kaolin, feldspar and quartz, are melting together. And this is making the transparency inside the body. So we have to see the difference of glazing, which cover the body, and the glazing inside the body. And this is very important to understand. So I have here another plate, which is from a very, very, very popular porcelain brand. They explain themselves as porcelain. And when you look to the catalogs and when you look to the selling skills, they always display this kind of porcelain as vitrified alumina. And I turn my light on to make the test if this kind of vitrified porcelain is a true porcelain. And I put here my light on, and I think you can see that there is more or less no light. So this comes from the substitution of kaolin to a lower temperature clay. Means that this kind of vitrified alumina is not a true porcelain. This is, let me say, a kind of ceramic, a kind of stoneware, because the firing temperature is much more low. They substitute the kaolin to some normal, we call it white firing clay. So the clay become white during firing. And also very interesting, there is no detection for the porcelain. They cover also the backside by the glaze. And I can tell you that this vitrified is not true porcelain. I have another very interesting group. This is the new bone china. Sorry, I only got muck in new bone china. But you see that the transparency is very, very, very good here. So if you think that this transparency is a symbol of quality, I'm sorry to tell you that this is not true. Because the transparency of this kind of body comes out from melting window glass. Means the raw material factory substitute the kaolin to melted window glass. What comes out? It comes out a very good transparency, but the stability of the body is much more low than the true feldspar porcelain. So this is the reason why we call this kind of material not ceramic and not stoneware. This is a porcelain imitation. Porcelain imitation is always declared for a material which shows one character from the porcelain without having the other characters. So the transparency here from the newborn China is very good, but the stability of the body is very low. So coming to the last group, to give you the true figure, how to detect the porcelain. I have here some porcelain plates which are covered by a kind of reactive glaze. So the pigments inside the glaze, they covered fully the transparency of the body. So if you see some reactive glaze porcelain like that, you have no transparency. So means that this kind of light testing for the porcelain is only valid for the white body porcelain. If you have some special decals or if you have a full color glaze, then this kind of illumination test did not work. And this is really true porcelain. I know it, not from laboratory, because I attend the production to make this test. For your information, this is the new collection Holz Porcelain 2020. This is a 100% hard porcelain, feldspar porcelain by reactive glaze. This is very important to know. So I thank you very much for your time. I thank you very much to listen to me, and I hope you had information for your work, and see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.